Hey everybody, my name is Sean Bryan. I'm a fellow young adult of Northern California, and I'm also known as the Papal Ninja on NBC's show American Ninja Warrior.
Are you serious?
Today's Pentecost, and I was asked to talk to you about my relationship with the Holy Spirit. How fitting it is that we're here at St. Albert Priory. Actually, no, we're in the basement of St. Albert Priory. Let me show you.
Camera two.
Hi, Father Michael. However fitting it is that we're at a sacred place like this, a place that's set apart for a holy purpose, it would be just as fitting if I brought you to my gym. Let's go. So here we are at Traverse Fitness. This is my gym in Richmond, California. And it's also fitting that we're here too. Let me explain. The Holy Spirit is not only our comforter, our consoler, the Spirit of God that leads us to all truth and the truth will set you free and all that stuff, but it enables something. It enables a particular seeing and a particular standing in our Lord's place. And we know from the Second Vatican Council documents that we're called to stand in our Lord's place in the world where the web of our existence is woven. And here, this gym is my world. It's the world in which I live to evangelize a secular society. But this all seems like theory. This all seems like just theology. I said that I was going to talk about my relationship with the Holy Spirit. How is it that my relationship with the Holy Spirit is informing what I'm saying right now? Let's talk about this. I want to tell you about a prayer. It's a prayer to the Holy Spirit that my spiritual director gave me. He gave it to me to pray just before my competitions, because sometimes I get a little nervous beforehand. But when I started praying it, I realized this is for everyone. It's not just for me. So I put it on papalninja.com. It's on the homepage. And I'd like to pray this prayer with you and also explain a little bit about it, some behind the scenes, if you will. So it starts out with like this. Come, Holy Spirit, be my strength. So I'm actually summoning the Holy Spirit to be my strength, not just spiritual strength, but also physical strength, like when I'm on the show. Banish from my heart all of my fear, all of my doubt, all of my shame. I'm really asking our Lord to do this because if I have fear, if I have doubt, if I have shame, all these things are lies and they get in the way. They get in the way of our real relationship with our Lord, and they get in the way of actually enabling us to see with Him, which is the next part of the prayer. So help me to see with You. Help me to move with You. Help me to rejoice with You and to rest with You, rest in You. So all these things, fear, doubt, and shame, they get in the way. They don't enable us to do what we practiced if we're doing stuff for the show. They don't enable us to live a life of virtue or heroic virtue for saints, because we're called to be saints, aren't we? So they don't allow these things. So that's why it's important to ask that the Holy Spirit comes into our hearts to banish from our hearts all the fear, the doubt, and the shame. We heard in the readings today that our Lord says, peace be with you. And He says this before He sends the Spirit and gives us the Spirit. It's really important that we have peace in our hearts so that we can truly be with Him, to see with Him. And this sort of dynamic isn't just, like I said, for before I compete. Yes, it does help me see differently the obstacles. It helps me to move as my body's been trained to move. But this also extends into my daily life. As I encounter a person, it helps me see the person as they truly are, as a child of God, as a unique and unrepeatable manifestation of the human mystery. It helps me to see these things when I'm encountering someone. It helps me to move with them. Another thing that means, not just move like when I'm on an obstacle, but also to act with Him. So it's not just, okay, Jesus was here and now I'm acting in His place, but no, I'm acting with Him in His place. The Spirit enables us to do this. So help me to see with You, help me to move with You, help me to rejoice with You. That really means help me to not just do really well on the show and then I'll celebrate the things that I do well. No, the very fact that I'm acting with Him helps me to, actually motivates me to do this, and it also wells up inside me this rejoicing, because I know I'm with Him, I know I'm walking with my friend and my Lord in His place. So help me to see with You, move with You, rejoice with You, to rejoice in what You rejoice in, and to rest with You. This rest is really important. Remember, we talked about how peace has to be in our hearts in order to really act in His place. But before we could pray the whole prayer together, we actually have to talk about the last part of the prayer. Conform my heart to Jesus, who is Christ and Lord. So everything that we just prayed, banish from my heart my fear, doubt, and shame, help me to see with You, help me move with You, all these things are actually the conforming. Those are the things that are really molding us to really see with Him, to really be with Him and act in His place. If we rejoice in what He rejoices in, if we prioritize as he prioritizes. We see things as he does. We really are conforming our hearts. So this prayer is kind of just a reminder to us what just happened. So conform our hearts to Jesus, who is Christ and Lord. And why? That we may proclaim him to the glory of God the Father, because this is our calling. So I'm going to get comfy, and let's pray this prayer together. All right, now that we're comfy, in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Come, Holy Spirit, be my strength. Banish from my heart all of my fear, my doubt, my shame. Help me to see with you, move with you, rejoice with you, rest in you. Conform me to Jesus, who is Christ and Lord, that I may proclaim him to the glory of God the Father, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for praying with me, and I really hope that something that I said is of spiritual benefit to you, that you could really see with our Lord, move with him, and act in his place in the world through your relationship with the Holy Spirit. All right.